Welcome, I'm the Mad Catster, and I'm here with my buddy Squirt, who's here to keep me company. But today we're going to talk about Erika Jayne of Real Housewives fame. She's got herself into quite a scandalous legal mess, and I'm going to go over it with you, give you a synopsis in plain language of what's going on. So Erika Jayne is married to Tom Girardi, or they're actually, I don't know if they're divorced or in the process of getting divorced, but I know she did file for divorce in December. But anyways, her husband, her former husband, Tom Girardi, is an attorney. He had his own law firm. He got accused of mishandling money that was intended for survivors of a Lion Air plane crash. I believe he's about 82 now, and he's got dementia from Alzheimer's, and it's my understanding that he's in an assisted living facility now. But the scandal is his firm had given Erika Jayne an American Express card in her own name. And on top of that, not only was she making charges for her personal businesses and herself on that card, but she was also getting other bills paid, like talent agency bills, et cetera, that the law firm of her husband was paying for her. And she racked up quite a bill. It's like about $25 million worth of expenditures that her husband's law firm ended up paying for. So Tom Girardi filed for bankruptcy, and he filed for what's called Chapter 7 bankruptcy, which is the most common bankruptcy. It's usually for individuals who have so much unsecured debt that they can't possibly pay their creditors. And so it's called a liquidation bankruptcy. And basically, the trustee, bankruptcy trustee, is appointed by the court, will take control of the person's assets. They get certain exemptions from the federal government of stuff that they can keep. And then the rest of it they sell to try to raise money to pay whatever they can to the outstanding creditors. There are also what's called secured creditors, and those are people like the bank that has your mortgage on your house, your car loan. Those are things that are backed by collateral. So if you default on your mortgage, they can take your house. If you default on your car payment, they can take your car, and that's how they're secured. But these other creditors, like your credit card companies, personal loans, and things like that, those people have no security. So if you go bankrupt and you don't have any money to pay them, they're left out and they're screwed, because Chapter 7, after it's finalized, all of your outstanding unsecured debts get discharged, which means they're basically canceled. So anyways, Tom Girardi filed for Chapter 7 bankruptcy. And the trustee, in going through the bankruptcy estate and going through the law firm's records, saw that Erika Jayne's companies and herself, and that she was getting all of these payments on her behalf. So the bankruptcy trustee has filed a lawsuit against Erika Jayne, and she wants Erika Jayne to pay back the $25 million. And what she's saying to the court, I read through the documents today, the trustee told the court, basically, this was money was a loan to Erika Jayne that she now has to pay back, and we're demanding that she pay it back with interest, and we can use that money to help pay some of Tom Girardi's creditors. She really trash talks Erika Jayne, and they say some pretty nasty things about her in there. So it's not just like a straightforward, here are the facts and this is why we think she should repay it argument. They said there is no glam without a sham, and some stuff like that. It's just like real name calling. First problem is there was no written agreement between Tom Girardi and Erika Jayne that any of this money was supposed to be paid back, or it was any kind of a loan arrangement or anything like that. So that's the first problem. The second problem is the payments were made to different creditors like American Express, the talent agency, other vendors. So all of these payments, it wasn't like he wrote a check to Erika Jayne and said, here, Erika Jayne. Because what happens is the trustees try to find instances where the person who filed bankruptcy might have tried to move money or hide money or assets before they filed bankruptcy, and that's fraud, obviously. And so she's kind of saying that, oh, Erika Jayne knows this money belongs to the estate, you know, these payments on her behalf shouldn't have been made. But it's not so cut and dry, because Erika Jayne, like I said, didn't get a payment to her. It wasn't like he wrote her a check. So that's the other problem. And to say that, now try to say, well, Erika Jayne was made a loan, it's a little thin, I think, the argument that she's making. And also to say that Erika Jayne is responsible for these payments, when clearly, even though the card was, she was an authorized user on the American Express card, that ultimately the responsibility was Tom Girardi and his law firm. They are the ones who signed the credit agreement. So I think that this lawsuit, in my opinion, it's not going to be a winner for the trustee. I think Erika Jayne might win this, but Erika Jayne's not out of the woods, because the big problem is, even though it wasn't money that went directly to her, she has to declare that somewhere, because that is income, even though it was somebody else paid it. Like if your friend John pays your $5,000 American Express bill, even though you didn't pay that or didn't receive that money, that's still income to you. The IRS considers that income because you've got a benefit, a financial benefit from that. And so you have to declare that as income. So if she didn't declare that as income on either her business's taxes or her taxes, then she's going to be in big trouble with the IRS, and there's going to be potential legal liability there in terms of fines and possible jail time. She could get convicted of tax fraud, but it depends on how she treated it.
Her 2018 tax returns, you can see that Erika Jayne deducted over $2 million worth of work-related and production-related expenses. So if she is deducting things that were paid by the firm, then those are improper deductions, and she's going to be in big trouble.
Law firm paying somebody who's not, has nothing to do with the law firm, paying her personal expenses, that's not kosher. That's it. A totally unethical thing to be doing. And I don't know how Tom Girardi and his firm, how they treated those payments. Did they write them off on their taxes? If they did, they're going to be screwed there too, because that's tax fraud, because you can't write off expenses from your wife and your wife's companies and call that business expenses as part of your law firm. So I'm going to be interested to see how this develops. I'll be interested to see now where this suit goes with the bankruptcy trustee. I'll keep you updated as things come along. I appreciate you watching. Please hit the like button, Squirt, and this is Clarice. Clarice and Squirt and I and the other cats, we'd appreciate if you hit the thumbs up and subscribe if you'd like to keep on top of what I'm doing. Please check out my other videos and take care. Have a good day.
Party, please. Subscribe, like, and hit the bell. I get a treat for every new sub. Thank you.